I'm impressed, Doug.
I'll try to be quiet. Pretty fancy
equipment that you can haul. Well, obviously a lot more than I can haul on my back.
Yeah.
I got a question for you, Doug.
Certainly.
You know, if I pack in this country and horses and mules and I throw a shoe, I carry spare shoes and some equipment that I can put them back on and make do. If I'm in my pickup or my Jeep and I blow a tire, obviously I got a spare tire and a jack. These things don't have any spare tires. What do we do? I mean, what?
We die. We're at the mercy of the environment. Yeah. No, actually, that's what you're carrying right here, Tim. You know, inside here is
a repair kit?
Yeah, there's just a few simple tools in case bolts come loose, but that's very seldom the problem. What we usually do is puncture, put a piece of greasewood or something through either the tread or the sidewall. And so I've got tire patch kits that we just clean the tire out, put a real gooey plug that'll seal it, and then a couple aerosol cans of
air
that'll fill it back up.
How many pounds do these things hold, roughly?
Well, we run about 3 to 4 pounds.
So
factory specs say about 3.5. No, but it's a lot of volume, but it doesn't take a lot of air.
So a can or two of aerosol will fill these?
One can would do it. But then a lot of times if you know, when you're out this far, you got to be prepared because you may do it again. You know, especially I'm famous for that. You know?
So you could actually patch a tire quicker than I could change one on my pickup, or obviously faster than I could put a shoe on.
We could have probably had this patched in the length of time we talked about it, if it was a nice clean hole. If there was just a stick sticking through that and that was flat, by now I would have had it fixed.
You know, I said this before, I'm impressed. These things are incredible.
It's amazing,
I like them,
isn't it?
I like them.
Well, is that your? That's a lightweight chair. Let me get your real chair, Tim.
Oh,
let's do this right.
That's my backpack chair.
Oh, okay.
Look at this. I like it. I like
it
already.
See, you don't have to worry about being so lightweight.
Doug, we got
to
do this more often.
Let me see here. Get this
out
of your
way. Boy, now this is life. This is the way to look for sheep.
Okay.
Now hopefully we can find some.
Yeah.
Doug, I found some sheep.
You're kidding. You got something?
You bet. We're on the side of this hill. You might want to take a look at them.
Put my toys down.
Yeah, here, let me just move this just a little bit and you can take a look. Okay, here you go. You see? They're way over there.
Wow. That's incredible. Wow, this thing's got some reach though.
Yes, it does.
No wonder I wouldn't be able to see him with my own eyes. Whoa.
Pretty hard to even, if I didn't know they were there, I couldn't even find them with these binoculars, I don't think, Doug.
Now, okay, so now this road, this little trail we're on, would we spook them if we try to get up there closer?
Well, this trail is going to go about another quarter of a mile, three quarters of a mile. If we were to go to the end of it, I would say we probably would.
Okay.
Yeah, we'd be on foot from here.
Wow.
Why don't we keep this hill at our back, work our way over here a little ways and go a little bit and get a different angle and see what we can see. If there are more there, we got a good chance of seeing them if we get over here.
Okay. Well, let's do it because then we get a...
Let's grab a little backpack and go.
Okay, let's do it. Oh, did you say we have to walk? That sheds a whole different light on it now. Well, as you're about to see, our day was cut just a little bit shorter than we had planned when the Traxtor, which served as our camera rig for Steve, not only flatted the front tire, but took it off the bead as well. Okay, well into that. This is what ATVing is all about right here. It's trying to, I'm gonna pull it off of our rock.
What can I do to help you, Doug?
We gotta get it back on this rock better. Well, let me try to lift it and you can slide those rocks on. Why can't we be?
It's under there.
Hey, whoa, too far?
Yeah. A little more. Okay,
good. That's all I had in me. Well, let's just see if a can will do anything or if we lose it too much. Because that's gonna be the secret, is if we can have enough air to inflate that and seat the bead. All right, we're in luck here. Well, you know, that's one of the problems with going on rides is I'm always left to clean the ATVs up and clean the gear up. But you know what? I don't mind. Hunts like that, exploring the outdoors, what better things to do? Bighorn sheep especially. What an exclusive game to get to go out and search for. Now, you know what? If you like bighorn sheep, if you're interested in bighorn hunts, Steve, the editor for the show, and Tim Mercer put together a video here with two actual hunts, plus some tips on how to rate the bighorn, how to use a spotting scope. You can find it right here on the website, Steve, if you want to type that in or something so I don't have to remember that. Get it right there. It's a great tape to see if you're interested in bighorn sheep. You know, great thing to watch. Hey, I always love that. I love exploring, and I love hunting for game. I love any excuse to get out riding. Plus, I think we taught Tim a thing or two on liking ATVs. So, hey, till next time, happy trails, and God bless.
Spotting scope out, and let's see what we can find.
All right, I'm game. No pun intended.
Way over there.